Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Chembiosis. So in this lecture I am going to discuss about the conformational analysis. So this conformational analysis part will be divided into some chapters or some lectures, and this is the first lecture of that lecture series. Now first of all, let's see the example of this molecule. So as you can see in the screen, this is an example of ethane molecule, where you can see that these two are carbon molecule and these two carbon molecules are joined with each other by sigma bond, and both this carbon molecule has other three carbon hydrogen bonds. Now this carbon carbon bond can rotate around its sigma bond. Okay, so you can see that if we take another example, suppose instead of hydrogen it is being replaced by some groups like methyl, then we get this compound. Now same thing happen if in this compound that this carbon-carbon sigma bond rotation occur, and we get this conformation of this molecule. Now you can see that this molecule is three-dimensional structure. If you see of this molecule, it has different structure than this molecule. Okay, so as you can see that this temporary molecular shape that we are getting due to the C-C sigma bond rotations are called conformations of the molecule. Okay, so all these structure or the shapes that we are getting are basically temporary, that we will discuss later half of this lecture series. So you can see that due to this sigma-sigma bond rotation around this carbon-carbon sigma bond, we get these types of different three-dimensional structures. They have different shapes and they are called conformations, and each of these structures are called conformers. Now one thing you should know, that while the sigma-sigma bond rotation, suppose that we are getting this structure, so while getting from this structure to this structure, the molecule should needs at least some minimum energy to cross over some threshold barrier. Okay, so you can see that there should be at least some energy required to get from this conformer to another conformer, and the energy that is required is sometimes also we call activation energy. So the analysis of the energy change that occur as a molecule undergoes rotation about single bond is called conformational analysis. So in a conformational analysis, we try to figure out what is the basically the energy changes that is associated while one conformer converted into another one. So this is basically called conformational analysis, and in this lecture series we are going to discuss about the conformational analysis of some known compounds, some 3-4 compounds I will take, and I will show you how to do the conformational analysis of those compounds. Okay. Now during that conformational analysis, one thing you should know, that you should have a proper idea to draw Newman projection. Okay, so there are basically two types of structural drawing formula. One is called the Newman projection formula and another is called the Sawhorse formula. So in the previous slide, whatever you have seen, that in which way I have drawn the structure of the molecules is basically a Sawhorse formula, and this is called the Newman projection formula. So in this slide I am going to discuss how you could draw these types of Newman projection formula and these types of Sawhorse formula. In the whole lecture series of the conformational analysis, I will mainly most of the time I will use Newman projection formula, but you should have a very clear idea how to draw these types of Newman projection formula and Sawhorse projection formula of different types of compounds. So let's take some example. Okay, now suppose we have a molecule like ethane C2H6. Okay, so first of all, you know that the very simple structure of this ethane molecule is like this, that we used to draw. So each carbon should have four bond connectivity around it. So this is the simplest way we can draw the structure of ethane molecule. But actually, the structure of this molecule is way different than this. Okay, so to actually manipulate or to draw the structure, at first we have to draw one straight line. So first of all, I will teach you how to draw the sawhorse formula. So first of all, draw these types of line. Okay, some angled line you should draw. Now this is one carbon, center of one carbon, and this is center of another carbon. You can see that I can label these two carbon. Suppose this is carbon number one and this is carbon number two. So similarly, we labeled it as carbon number one and this as carbon number two. Now we can draw three bond. As you know that the carbon atom should bonded to total four bonds. So one carbon-carbon bond I have already drawn. So rest of the three bonds are three carbon-hydrogen bond, as you can see. And in each case, we are maintaining an angle of at least 120 degrees. So you can see this is hydrogen, this is hydrogen, this is hydrogen. And similarly here, this is hydrogen and this is hydrogen. So this is the way we can draw the sawhorse formula. So you can see that from any, you can see from this point of view. If you see from this point of view, this is the front carbon and this is the carbon that is just behind you. Okay, so this is the way we can draw the sawhorse formula. Let's take some more complicated example like CH3CH2CH2CH3. Okay, this is another molecule that I am going to draw its sawhorse formula. Similarly, we have to draw these types of line. So these two line basically signifies these two carbon hydrogen carbon atom. So we are right now we are focusing about the sigma bond rotation around this two carbon atom. Okay, so while drawing the Newman projection formula or while drawing the sawhorse formula, you should have a clear idea that for which carbon carbon sigma bond rotation you are going to analyze the we are going to do the conformational analysis. So you can see that in this molecule mainly we are focusing about the conformational analysis due to the sigma sigma bond rotation around these two carbons. So that's why we should draw like this. Okay, so these two carbon are marked as 1 and 2. Okay, now you can see that one carbon is attached with methyl group. So we draw one methyl group, and rest of the rest of this are carbon hydrogen bonds. So carbon hydrogen bond. Similarly, another carbon atom, that is this carbon atom, carbon number two, it is attached with one methyl group. So we draw one methyl group, and rest of the bonds are carbon hydrogen bond. Okay, so this is the way we can draw the sawhorse formula. Now coming back to the Newman projection formula. So how you can draw the Newman projection formula for this compound? First of all, we should discuss about this compound. So first of all, suppose that we are seeing from this end. Okay, so suppose we are seeing from this end. So this carbon is the front carbon and this carbon is the back carbon. So first of all, you have to draw a circle. Okay, so you can see that in that circle, and you are seeing through this angle, you are seeing through this angle. I am very bad at drawing, so please bear with me. So you can see that at first you draw like this, Okay, so this carbon is the front carbon, that is this carbon, and there is another carbon that is behind this circle or sphere, whatever you say, that we cannot see. So this is the back side of the carbon, that is this carbon. So in the front side of the carbon, this carbon is attached with total three hydrogen atoms. So hydrogen, 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 and in the back side of the carbon, this back side carbon is also attached with three hydrogen atom. So we will draw like this: hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. So you can see now this Sauer's formula is now converted into Newman projection formula. Okay, similarly, if you try to draw the Newman projection formula for this structure, similarly, if you are seeing from this angle, so again, first of all, draw the sphere. Okay, then you can see that here the alignment is like this. So you can see this is the front carbon, and that is attached with one methyl group, and this front carbon is also attached with two hydrogen atom. And in the behind that circle, this is the carbon atom, that is the behind that circle, and it is attached with one methyl group as well as two hydrogen atom. So this is the Newman projection formula for this compound. So I guess that if you do practicing like this for different types of compounds, it is there will not be any problem to draw these types of Newman projection formula. So it is just a matter of practices. So while drawing the Newman projection formula, you should be careful that this face, this is basically the front carbon. So this is the front carbon, and the back side of this is called the back side carbon. Similar to that, this is the front carbon and this is the back side carbon. Okay, so I guess that now you have some clear cut idea about how to draw Newman projection and Sauer's formula. Now coming back to, there are basically two types of conformation that is very much important while we will do the conformational analysis. The first one is called the staggered conformation. So you can see this is a ball and stick model for ethane C2H6. So this is the ball and stick model for ethane. Okay, so these two are carbon compound and these are basically hydrogen atoms. Now if you draw two planes through this carbon carbon and this hydrogen, so suppose we draw one plane. Okay, so this is one plane. Okay, so this is one plane, and again if you draw another plane using this two carbon atom and this hydrogen atom, so this is another plane. So you can see that these two planes are basically 180 degree with each other. So the angle between these two planes is called dihedral angle, which is 180 degree. Dihedral angle. So this is the new terminology that you have just listened now. So you can see that the staggered conformations are those conformations where this dihedral angle between the bonds at each of the carbon-carbon bonds is 180 degree. And in case of staggered conformations, the each of these carbon-carbon bonds or carbon-hydrogen bonds are as far apart as possible. So the distance between these hydrogens or these hydrogens are as maximum as possible. So in case of any staggered conformation, there is will be very minimum steric effect. Okay, because all these atoms are as far apart as possible from each other. So that is called the staggered conformation. Okay, so you can see that if you see through this point, so suppose we are seeing through this, so this is our front carbon. So you can see this is the front carbon, and backside carbon we cannot see. Okay, backside carbon we cannot see. So you can see that this hydrogen atom is like this, this hydrogen atom is like this, and this hydrogen atom is like this, and in the backside carbon is also attached with three hydrogen atom like this, and the dihedral angle is basically this angle. So this is the Newman projection formula of this compound. So if you this is basically a ball and stick model, so from that ball and stick model also you can draw the Newman projection formula, similar like you have I have shown you how to draw the Newman projection from these types of Sawhorse formula. Okay, so you can see that this angle, that is called the dihedral angle, and in case of staggered conformation this dihedral angle is 180 degree and all the atoms are basically as far apart from each other. Now this is another type of conformation. This is neither, this is not a staggered conformation. So sorry, this is again this is a staggered same conformation we are drawing, but in this case we are mainly focusing on the dihedral angle between this hydrogen and this hydrogen. Okay, so how to draw the how to know the what is the basically the dihedral angle? This is the angle between this plane, so this is the plane that you have, it is drawn, and this plane. So this is basically the dihedral angle between this plane and this plane, and this angle is 60 degree. So the dihedral angle between these two hydrogen atoms is 60 degree. And in my previously I have shown you that the dihedral angle between this hydrogen and that is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So this is an example of a staggered conformation, so where all these atoms are as far apart from each other. In the next example I will show you the eclipsed conformation, where you will see that the dihedral angle between these two hydrogen will become 0 degree. Okay, so right now in case of an eclipsed conformation, the atoms bonded to carbons at each end of a carbon-carbon bond are directly opposed to one another. The dihedral angle between them is 0 degree. So in case of staggered conformation, what you have seen, that is in case of staggered conformation, you have seen that this is one carbon atom, and this is there is one carbon atom behind that, and the angle between this two hydrogen atom is 180 degree in case of staggered conformation. But in case of eclipsed conformation, this is an example of an eclipsed conformation for ethane molecule. So if you try to draw the Newman projection formula of that eclipsed conformation from that ball and stick model, so you can see that if you see from this angle, you will draw the eclipsed conformation like this. Okay, so you can see that these two hydrogens, if you see that these two hydrogen have 0 degree of dihedral angle between each other, so they are very close to each other, almost touching each other, these two hydrogen or these two hydrogen or these two hydrogen. So this types of conformation is called the eclipsed conformation, where the dihedral angle between this hydrogen atom is 0 degree between these hydrogens. Okay, and in case of staggered conformation, this dihedral angle is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so I think that's that is up to this. I think I will stop this lecture right now. In the next lecture series I am going to discuss about the real conformational analysis portion. So in that conformational analysis, I will show you different types of conformers of different types of compound like ethane, okay, or CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, or butane. Okay, so these types of compounds I will draw, and I will show you different types of conformational analysis for these types of compounds, And I hope that you like this lecture and you understood each and every aspect of this lecture. And if you do have any question, you can ask me through the comment section. So I will see you soon in my next lecture. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.